Hey guys, welcome to EdTech channel. In this video lecture, we are going to talk about the next part of solid state. We will discuss about the types of unit cell. So there are various type of unit cell. We'll go into depth of this unit cells. Next, we'll discuss about the coordination number. So this picture shows about one unit cell, the arrangement, and we'll talk about how many atoms are present in the specific unit cell. So without a doubt, let's start. So unit cell. There are various type of unit cell. We'll go one by one. So the first type of unit cell, that is simple or primitive unit cell. So in the primitive unit cell, atoms are only at the corner of the unit. So you can see this picture. This is one simple unit cell, or you can say the primitive unit cell. So in this primitive unit cell, the atoms are present on the corner. So how many corners in a cubic is present? Total 8 corners are there, okay? So in the 8 corners, your unit cells are present. So you can see this picture. This is a bigger picture. So in this picture, if you will join this 8 atom, we will get one simple unit cell. So you see this picture. So these corner atoms are joined together. Okay. So in a simple unit cell, atoms are present only at the corner. So atoms are present. Only at the corner. Okay. Now let us calculate how many atoms are present in a simple unit cell. So to understand that how many atoms are present, let us go to this picture. So this is a unit cell. Now a bigger picture is there. So in this bigger picture, if you look at the atom at this center, so this atom is attaching 8 unit cell. Can you see this? So in the above, there is 4. So this is one. So this is one. This is another. This is third one. And this is fourth one. So in the upper part, there is 4 cube is present. And in the lower part, there is 4 cube is present. So my question is, how many cube is sharing this one atom? So the answer is, 8 cube is sharing one atom, right? So now a bigger question is, what is the contribution of this atom in the each cube? So each cube is nothing but 1/8, because this atom is sharing 8 cubes, right? So per cube it will be 1/8. So what is the contribution of an atom in the corner? So the corner atom contribution is, this atom contribution is 1/8 of the total cube, right? So now we have to calculate the total number of atom in a cube. Total number of atoms in simple unit cell or primitive unit cell. Each atom contributing 1/8, right? So how many corners are there? 8 corners. So 1/8 into 8, that is one atom. So how many atoms are present in a simple or primitive unit cell? That is one atom. Okay. And you have to remember it. So next type of unit cell, that is face-centered cubic unit cell, or in the short form, we'll call it as a FCC. So in the FCC, atoms are present at the corners, remember, and center of each face. So you can see this picture. So atoms are present at the corner. So how many corners are there? 8 corners, okay? And atoms are present on the face. So how many face in a cube is present? Total 6 face. So in the 6 face, atoms are present. So this is a bigger picture or clarity of this picture. So these atoms, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, these are the face centered atom, and these are the corner atom. Okay, so now we have to calculate the total number of atoms. So total number of atoms can be calculated as total number of atom in FCC. So we have to calculate first the corners atom. So how many corners are there? 8 corners, right? So each corner contribute 1/8 and total 8 number of corners are there. Plus we have to add the face atom. So in the face atom, the contribution that is 1/2 of an atom, right? So how many faces are there? Total 6 faces. Each face contribute 1/2. So total 6 is, so if you'll calculate, so this is 1, this is 3. So total is 4 atom. So in the face center, total number of atom is 4 atom. So now just talk about the next part of unit cell, that is body centered cubic unit cell, or in the short form we'll call it as a BCC unit cell. So atoms are present at the corners, one part. Second part is one atom is at the body. So if you look at this picture, so atoms are present on the corners, so 8 corners are there and one atom is at the body. So if you'll see that a bigger big boss is there, so this is the complete atom is present inside the cube. So this is a schematic diagram. So how many corners are there? Total 8 corners and one atom is the center. So now let us calculate the total number of atom. So as we already calculate, how many corners are there? Total 8 corners. So each corner contribute, that is 8, and total 8 corners are there and one is the body center. So total will be 2 atom in BCC. Next type of unit cell, that is end center, or we'll say end face centered unit cell. Okay, so atoms are present at the corner plus particles are present on the end face of the unit cell. So you can see the schematic diagram. So atoms are present on the corners. So how many corners are there? Total 8 corners. So 8 corners atoms are present, and in the end there is 2 atoms are present. So one is above, another is the below one. So now let us calculate the total number of atom. 1/8 is the contribution of each atom at the corner into 8, because of 8 corners are present, and at the end is, that is 1/2. So this is the contribution, that is 1/2. Okay, so 1/2 is the contribution. So how many 1/2 atoms are there? Total 2. Okay, if you'll calculate it, that is 2 is the number of atom in the end face centered. Okay, sometime it is called end centered. Okay, so next we'll discuss about the coordination number. So what is coordination number? If the atoms are represented by sphere, the number of sphere which are touching a particular sphere. So the meaning is, in an arrangement of these atoms, the coordination number is the number of atom touching one particular atom. Okay, if you'll see in this diagram, atoms are arranged and one particular atom is touching 4 other atom, right? So this is the 4 number of atoms. Again, this atom is touching again 4 number of atoms. So that is the coordination number. So coordination number here, that is 4. Thank you for watching this video. If you have understood something from this video, then like this video and subscribe to EdChem channel to get more videos like this. And if you want to connect with me, my social media account, my Instagram and my Twitter handle is this. Till then, bye.